Here we go.
Here we got. Plumeria. Here we got. This is called a plumeria.
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 Plume.
Plume.
Yeah.
Oh, plumeria. I thought it was plumeria.
Yeah, how you see?
Right.
Learning by the second here. Two plumerias.
Right.
Both are cuttings.
Right.
These are both trees.
Right.
This is a cutting from an established tree. Older tree. That's why it's wrinkly like an old
tree. Right.
Yep. And this one's a bit leaner and leaner because it's a cutting from a newer one.
Cool.
Okay. Both from the same variety.
Right.
So they're called Plumeria rubla. Yeah, and it's basically a tree that is kind of interesting looking because all the branches are about this thickness pretty much. Whereas normally in trees you have a thick trunk and then thinner and thinner and thinner. You still get thick trunks when it's a tree, but when it's in the growing stages like in a pot, the weird thing about it is it looks like it's a fake one because all of the branches are kind of the same thickness.
Okay.
So it kind of looks weird, it doesn't look right. The other strange thing about it is that the flowers, rather than coming all over the shop like they would on a normal tree or a plant that you grow in a pot, a thick stem called an inflow sticks up one plant and all the flowers appear on that.
What are the
nowhere
flowers
else.
Like?
The flowers are the ones that they use a lot in those lays in like New Zealand and the Pacific Islands.
Right, so
they're kind of like a six petal, very, very pretty, very smells beautiful. And the flower is the national flower of Nicaragua.
Oh,
which
Nicaragua.
Is where his family is from. The actual species comes from Central and South America, kind of from Brazil all the way almost to Florida. So that's kind of the origin. But then,
so it's an American flower.
Yes, an American flower. Right. The sap is like a milky sap, a little bit like the ficus has, which is the, kind of like a latex. It's a little bit irritant. You don't want to be playing with that and then scratching your
mouth
or sticking your fingers in your eyes. You'll see that whenever a leaf breaks off or anything, it's like white sap pops out.
Okay.
And then the leaves are beautiful, big leaves. And again, they form as it grows. So rather than just popping out everywhere like you get on other plants, it's very uniform. And quite often, they'll drop as it grows. So you end up like kind of at the end, this big thing of leaves. Large leaves, a little bit like the nispero.
Right. Okay.
And they tend to lose them as they go up. Okay.
Right.
It takes about a month or so in the summer and a couple, 2 or 3 months in the winter to do the cut with the roots. And the roots of these plants are quite thick.
Right.
They're not your usual like little stringy things like that. They're kind of like little white. But this one, which is the one I got for you guys, the reason this one is special is this one has already, which is very unusual, flower inflow popping out there. Which means you're gonna get flowers on this straight away.
Yeah, right.
This may take a little bit longer.
Cool.
Okay.
Right, so before we continue, a little point of clarification, the when and the where. It's the 1st of June, so it's practically summer. And we are in the south of Spain, in Malaga. In good conditions for our plumeria?
Perfect.
Water bag.
How it goes.
Right, so.
Well, plumerias love heat, love sunshine. So you want to give as much sun and as much heat as you can. And we're in the perfect place for it because we're in the south of Spain.
Now,
can I just say, plumerias are also known as frangipanis.
Frangipanis? You mean like frangipan? The sweet? The cake?
It's still as frangipani. It sounds like somewhere between a sweet almond-type flavor mixed with a vagina.
Oh, God!
That's what the name sounds like. But it comes from the fact that the guy, it smells similar to a perfume, I think, that an Italian guy in the 16th century called Frangipani.
Nothing to do with vaginas and...
Nothing to do with marzipan or any of that sort of business. Plumeria is the original one over after the 15th century, I think. French botanist Plumier.
Right, again, let's get planting.
So, here's the specimen. This is gonna need a biggish one if you don't want to have to repot it anytime soon.
A big pot?
Biggish, as in.
Biggish. So
much bigger than this, than what it's
I can
at.
Offer you that huge pot. I can offer you the little one inside.
That'll be all right. What's in that one?
In which one?
That one here in the middle. With a bit of orange charge.
That,
looks deader than a pumpkin.
I have no idea. Is it dead?
Looks dead. That's white, isn't it? Yeah, the one much better.
Well, that's yours then.
That's a mini tree. Perfect size.
All right, do it.
Let's do this.
Oh yeah! One you just took out, that's a Mexican plant, isn't it?
Is it?
The Mexican desert.
Is it? It's completely dead.
The one you just put out, was that one?
Yeah, it's a shame.
Yeah, that's
dead. Completely gone.
That has been dead.
Okay. Thank you, Awesome. That was the grandmother. Grandmother offering her words of wisdom.
Here, look, here's the reason why we want to add some sand. See this here?
Yeah. It's all packed up. Yeah,
yeah. Right. What you want it, the consistency you want is this, even after it's been watered, you want it to be loose.
Right, okay.
That way the roots can get about, the water can get through it. Right. Everybody's a happy camper. So what we've done here is we've taken the soil that was in there was alright, so we just mixed it with some sand and making sure it's all broken up, and you don't really want any old bits of stuff like that, which one day will make good compost because when it decomposes it creates nutrition.
Yeah.
But in the process of decomposing it actually sucks nitrogen out of the soil, which you don't want. So you're going to take all those baddies out and you want to make sure it's nicely mixed in, so you just run through your hands and it's not clumpy. Get that into the pot. If we had a bit of slow release fertilizer, we'd chuck some at the bottom, but we don't, so we're not gonna. I'm just gonna fill around the pot in a magical sort of way. There's lots of different ways of doing this. Now, because it's well draining soil, you don't have to worry too much about compacting it. If you compacted the other soil, it would just turn into solid brick.
Right.
But the compacting it down a little bit gives you a little bit of stability, because these things, when they start getting all their leaves, they get really heavy. And then a little bit of wind, a little bit of that, and they have a habit of leaning in weird ways and all the weight going to one side. Now this is only just rooted, so it's not going to be root bound or anything like that. There'll barely be any roots. In fact, they're probably most of the soil's going to come off when I...
So is it safe to take it out of the pot?
Yeah, it'd be just gentle. Fall apart. Yeah. All right. You see, it's barely rooting. Some little roots there.
But that's all right. That happened, huh?
Yeah. I didn't break anything. It's okay. The fact that it's so loose soil that it didn't compact in at all, and just all came off when I did that. But okay, so that's all in there now. What we can do is we can chuck some of those bits of crockery that we took out from around it on the top. Because what this does, it's going to lose most of its moisture just evaporating in the hot sun. So it'll keep some of that moisture in now that we're in summer. If it was winter, well, you should really only be watering it once a month or something like that. You probably don't want the crockery in the top, because you do want it to evaporate. Otherwise, you don't want things to get rotten.
Right.
Now whenever you pot any plant, you've got to do what's called watering it through.
Right, so explain the problem again.
It's not draining quick enough. It means the hole's too small, the soil's too blocky. But it's, we're coming into summer, so it's not gonna be the end of the world, but the hole does feel tiny. Know what I mean?
Yeah. So
if you finger the hole a little bit, you can tell. You know, stuff coming out of it, but it's really, my finger barely fits into the hole. kind of sweat, but it's not the right kind of wet. We'll be okay.
So this frangipani can't be fingered.
Yeah, look, this is one dirty frangipani. I mean, it's draining. Yeah, we can see it's draining. Right. It's just not mega draining like I was hoping.
So, water it less or?
No, it's all right. I'll be fine because we're coming into the summer.
Right.
But probably when we repot in the winter, well, at the end of the summer, into a bigger pot, we'll buy some really fluffy. We'll get some perlite and mix in it with it, and that'll just air it out.
Well, job well done. Plumeria is now planted. She's been fingered. She's been soaked. And she is dripping.
You can't beat job well dripping done. Dripping frangipani.
For the dripping, what's it called? After a bit of gardening, nothing better than a few beers and some barbecue.